special. 3 years ago, I was blessed and honored to hear the story of this young man. And 3 years ago, compared to what he is today, is unbelievable. I can't tell you how proud I am of Joel Anderson. 3 years ago, I was at USD, University of San Diego, playing football there, and he came out to one of our spring practices, had a speech, and told us a story. After his speech, I went directly to my coach and said, "We have to get involved. We have to get involved." So with the help of Mrs. Anderson and the Autism Tree Project Foundation, we started a mentoring program with the USD football team and kids with autism. So from there, I started out as Joel's mentor. And we created a friendship from there. And now I consider him to be a brother. Joel Anderson is fighting severe OCD issues, like he mentioned. And in the last several weeks, he's gone to rigorous classes that has exposed his OCD and the toughness that it has on him. He is so strong. And like he said, we created a prayer support team. I have 10 of my USC football players that get together at a Bible study that I lead, and the first thing we do is pray for Joel Anderson. The first thing we do is pray for Joel Anderson. And as I've worked with kids with disabilities, people often say they suffer from a disability. And I'll tell them, no, they're not. They're blessed with a disability. They are blessed with this disability. Jesus took upon our image, their image, so that we may be given his. Joel is an image of that. Catherine is an image of that. Jasmine is an image of that. Chris is an image of that. We all are an image of that. And we all have a story. And like I said, our story, Joel's story, is an introduction to the gospel. I can't tell you how many people I've talked to and brought up Joel and I's story, and they've been changed. That's what today is about, and that's what every day after is about, is changing people's lives with the power of the Holy Spirit in our hearts. So this is a story that in Exodus 3:5, God is talking to Moses, and he says, "Don't come any closer. Take off your sandals, for the ground you are standing on is holy." And this touches my heart because Joel, as he said, doesn't do very well with the sensory, getting too close to people. So I thought that this Bible verse was perfect. But studying it, it wasn't as if this ground magically became holy. It was because Moses became aware of it. Everywhere we go, are we walking on holy ground? With Joel, I know that I am. I know that I'm walking on holy ground all the time. And the thing that I'm always asking myself is, am I passing burning bushes on my right and on my left? All these ministry opportunities. All these opportunities to tell Joel's story and to tell my story. Am I too busy or complacent? Your story, my story, can change lives. And people always, you know, you always hear people say, you know, you give so much, you do so much. How do you do it? But it's us It's the caregivers. It's the parents. It's the families. It's the support that receive the most. Thank you for the opportunity to be here today. It's a privilege and honor to speak on behalf of Joel and I and our friendship.